Daddy stayed a dose.
Adult facts through a baby's lips.
Hello there, I'm Cyrus, and I'm just 11 months old. My dad always says he has three main loves in his life. That's me, my mom, and fascinating facts. So here I am, ready to share the most astonishing and quirky stories that my dad discovers. But before we dive in, if you like what you hear, don't forget to give us a thumbs up, subscribe to our channel, and hit that notification bell so you won't miss out on any new episodes. Ready to embark on a journey through a world of intriguing facts with me? Recently, I discovered what stairs are. You walk on them every day, but did you know how unusual and amazing they can be? Dad introduced me to another staircase, and it's not the one at our house. This staircase is older than me, by a whopping 7,000 years. It was discovered in Haifa, Israel, at the Tel Tsafit archaeological site, which many scholars identify as the ancient city of Gath. Here's a fun twist. Ever heard of the giant Goliath, defeated by the young David from the Bible? Legend has it, this city might be Goliath's hometown. This relic staircase, dating back to around 5100 BC, consists of just 5 steps made out of chalky stone and leads straight to water. I really hope these steps weren't used like in those trendy TikTok videos. Did you know that the most widely distributed book in the world is the Bible? It's been translated into over 3,000 languages and dialects and has sold billions of copies worldwide. And guess what? Even in the Bible, stairs get a mention. In the book of Genesis 28:10-22, there's a story about Jacob having a dream where he saw a ladder set up on the earth, and the top of it reached to heaven. And behold, the angels of God were ascending and descending on it. In season 6, episode 12 of South Park, there's also a ladder to heaven. Could it be that the creators, Matt Stone and Trey Parker, had some kind of dream too? Or perhaps they drew inspiration from the biblical tale? Who knows? But one thing's for sure, their sense of humor knows no doubt. Speaking of imagination and creative thinking, long before South Park hit the screens, British mathematician Roger Penrose and his psychiatrist and geneticist father, Lionel Penrose, unveiled something extraordinary. In 1958, they crafted the impossible staircase, an optical illusion depicting an endless ascent, despite the staircase looping back onto itself. This brilliant design has inspired a myriad of architects and artists worldwide. If you've watched Christopher Nolan's Inception, you might have caught a reference to this unique staircase.
You're gonna have to master a few tricks if you're gonna build 3 complete dream levels. Excuse me.
What kind of tricks?
In a dream, you can cheat architecture into impossible shapes. That lets you create closed loops, like the Penrose steps.
Have you ever considered taking on the Empire State Building run-up? It's a renowned tower race that's been held since 1978. Participants face the challenge of sprinting up 86 flights, that's 1,576 steps. While the fastest runners conquer this in roughly 10 minutes, most visitors reach the observatory in under a minute by elevator. But if you decide to participate, the next race is set for the 4th of October, 2023, at 8 p.m. And let's be honest, given the choice between all those stairs and the elevator, most of us know which we choose. The first elevator patent was granted in 1857 in the United States to Elisha Graves Otis, renowned as the founder of the Otis Elevator Company and the inventor of a safe elevator system equipped with emergency brakes. However, the history of elevators extends back much further, and pinpointing their exact invention date is challenging. Elevators, as we recognize them today, began to take shape in the early 1800s. During this era, they were often steam-powered and frequently found in hotels. The shift towards electric elevators occurred around the early 1900s. A significant landmark in the history of elevators was the construction of the Equitable Life Building in Manhattan in 1870, marking the first installation of elevators in an office building. Each elevator had its operator, even though automated or operator-less elevators had been invented. It wasn't until after World War II that Otis Elevator Company developed the automatic elevator system, which only required selecting a floor to initiate door closure. Mistrust of automatic elevators was rooted in safety concerns. Operators reassured passengers, earning their trust by manually managing the elevator's operation. Elevators with operators became integral to modern society, handling everyday tasks. However, for most of the 20th century, it was challenging to imagine elevators without operators. Everything changed after the 1945 elevator operator strike. In 1945, shortly after World War II ended, around 15,000 elevator operators in commercial buildings across New York City went on strike, causing the city to come to a grinding halt. Strike resulted in a staggering $100 million economic loss for the city and mobilized over a million workers in support. In the following years, the introduction of emergency phones and emergency stop buttons gradually enhanced the safety of automated elevators. It's important to note that these safety features were implemented gradually, along with other safety measures, and it took quite some time for them to become widespread. Later, in 1950, an automated elevator was installed in an oil refinery building in Dallas, marking the beginning of the end for elevator operators. By the 1970s, most elevators were operating without operators. Today, automated elevators are one of the safest modes of transportation. However, they still account for accidents that claim 27 lives each year and injure around 10,000 individuals, primarily during maintenance procedures. As we dive deep into history and technology, we often find patterns echoing through time. Just as we once couldn't fathom elevators without our trusted operators, a similar tale unfolds in the automotive world. A journey from manual to automatic, from human touch
to artificial intelligence.
Picture the streets of San Francisco, once dominated by cable cars, now witnessing a new kind of traveler. Driverless taxis, pioneered by companies such as Waymo and Cruise, have taken to the streets. Can you visualize cars without drivers? Sounds like something out of sci-fi, doesn't it?
Hi, is there a problem, officer?
Hi, where's the driver?
But it's no fiction. Yet, as with any technological evolution, opinions are divided.
I think the technology is amazing. It feels like we're living with the Jetsons.
I think it's not safe, despite them saying it is safe. I think it's going just one step too far.
The debate rages on, highlighting the ever-present dance between progress and caution. As we navigate this new era, where do you stand? Wow, the way technology keeps evolving, right? Just as we're trying to wrap our heads around cars without drivers, we're here to throw another surprise your way. In honor of my first video, I'm launching a giveaway for 5 subscribers. Each of the 5 winners will get $100. The selection of winners will take place on September 16th using the Comment Picker service on commentpicker.com. And we'll show the results on September 17th in our next video. All you need to do is leave a comment below, sharing your thoughts on today's episode. Are you excited, skeptical, or just curious? Let us know. Make sure you're subscribed to the channel and have activated notifications so you don't miss a winner announcement. So, are you ready to participate? Dive into the comments and start the discussion. Thank you for being with me today. Even though I'm just an 11 months old baby, I loved sharing this amazing story with you. Don't forget to participate in the giveaway, and I'll see you next time.